great to have you back.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
All right. The whole Mardi Gras getup.
Yeah.
On Saturday. Tell us about it.
Well, it's the first time we've had them, and we're super excited. I think, you know, Nike designed these uniforms, and we have some shoes to match, and we're super excited about it.
Festive.
It is festive. You know, it's we live in such a unique place, and no one else can go out there and really do the whole Mardi Gras thing and really do it justice, and I'm excited about it.
No, I looked on the schedule, February 18th. I will be following you on the game tracker,
okay,
but I won't be at the game because I think you're at Cincinnati that day, right?
Cincinnati. Yeah.
Yeah. So that Saturday, I'm kind of a little bit removed from reality. My apologies.
Yeah. It's Mardi Gras.
It's Mardi Gras.
I understand.
Exactly. All right. The whole record, you're too short of Barmore, 574. Is that kind of, I remember when you got to 500.
Yeah.
It seemed like yesterday.
Yeah.
How big is that number to you?
Well, I think, what's special is being a part of this state and the tradition of basketball in this state. You look at the tradition of Louisiana Tech, and really to be in that same sentence talking about, you know, just what Leon was able to do, you know, I feel like it's a great honor.
You look very energized. You don't look bored to me. You want to do this for a while, right?
Yeah, I don't know how you can be bored in our profession, that's for sure. But yeah, I'm loving it. I am. I think our players energize you every day when you go to work.
So all of those years, has the message changed a lot or not?
I think the style has changed a lot. I don't know if the message has. Mm-hmm. You know, I definitely think that we coach differently now than I did year one. But I think the message of getting out there and competing every day and trying to take one game at a time and all those kind of things are still the same. And, you know, we just maybe have a little different delivery.
Not that you are, but do you feel any fear about being harsh with a player that maybe now it would backfire on you and maybe 29 years ago when you got here it wouldn't?
Well, you certainly think about that. You know, I definitely think that things are perceived a lot differently, and you raise your voice and you say things. I definitely believe there's coaches that aren't in this profession anymore because that wasn't something they could change. I definitely think you need to think about it, and I think about it more, about how you handle certain situations. You might have to step back and take a breath.
So what's the team rule on social media? Do you have parameters that all the young ladies have to abide by?
Well, I think we do a pretty good job early to talk to them about just how much they reflect our university and our program. We certainly have a lot of people watching their social media. And it's definitely something that we have to pay attention to. We have some rules and some guidelines that we go by. So far, we've been okay. We haven't had too many problems. But you know, it's definitely a reality of today's athletics.
All the years that you've been coaching, is there one that got away that still, after all these years, drives you absolutely bananas?
Kind of feel like a lot of them got away sometimes when you don't finish how you want. But, you know, I think Grace Daly's senior year, where, you know, we had been ranked in the top 15 at times. You know, we lost at Duke in the second round, and we felt like if we had made it to the Sweet 16 that year, we could have really made a run. So that was probably the team that I felt like had the most talent and the most potential that we probably didn't get as far as I wanted to.
Are there wins along the way that you said, you know what, we absolutely stole this one?
Yes.
A bunch,
definitely.
Yeah?
I think that you go in and I think I can remember more that got away.
Sure.
But, you know, you go in there thinking you can win everything. But I definitely think that there's games that you feel like, you know, that was a great performance. And I even take, it wasn't a win, but I even take our three-point loss here to UConn when they were on their 101 win streak. You know, we lost by three and played well and really stepped up. And I think I was so proud of our players of just the moment of handling that moment.
So what do you think the rest of this year looks like? And what do you think the future looks like?
Well, you know, for us, I think we've been a little inconsistent in the last few weeks. You know, we've had some really good wins, and I think we've had a couple bad losses. But, you know, we've got a lot of game to play. You know, we've got February. Last February, we didn't lose a game. You know, I think we can go into it, and with the rest of our schedule, I think we can finish really strong. I think we're talented. Our tournament's up for grabs. I think our tournament could be anybody. Now that we got UConn out of the league, it makes a big difference. But, you know, I think we're excited about, you know, what this month can bring and what we can do in Fort Worth at the tournament.
So you were able to galvanize last year during this time. What is that just a... That, does that just happen? Is it an accident, or is there something that you can do specifically to kind of trigger that?
Well, I think a lot of it, you know, this time of year, it's time for the players. You know, it's time for all the work they've put in to be able to take that baton and run with it. Mm-hmm. You know, last year we had five seniors, and they were fifth-year seniors. And I think that they got to this time of the year, and they were really extremely focused. You know, mm-hmm. This year we have a different dynamic in that I think you've got people that are new to the program, even if they're fifth year. I think that is the different challenge. But I certainly think we can make the same run. It's just maybe a little different dynamic.
We're hearing so much more about the commitment to athletics and how, you know, the Cotton Bowl team has changed so much, not only for the football program, but perhaps for the athletic program as well. Do you feel that, and how would that affect you in a positive way?
Well, I certainly hope. I think when we joined the American, there was definitely an increase in support. But I think this year, you know, showing what we can do, what Willie did this year with his program, I think really shows what you can do. I think Ron's doing an amazing job. You know, I think our administration, our board of trustees, I think our president kind of see what athletics can be. And, you know, we've got some money from the conference coming in, even though it's a realignment. Where can we be in that realignment? I think that's huge for us. Are we going to be in the top three or four in that realignment? So I think it would help us. If you help the program, you're going to help women's basketball. There's no doubt. And so, you know, I look forward to what happens, you know, and what facilities and all of that. I think that will enhance all of our programs.
So the whole NIL thing, I know every time you come here, we talk about that. Is that something that you think can be enhanced for women's basketball?
It can be, and I think it will be. I think we've kind of put ourselves in a position now going forward that we can, that can be an enticement or keep people here. You know, you look at Willie being able to keep his people here. I think that's important in building a program. Definitely think that's it. I think it's really tough to compete sometimes with the Power Fives just because of all the money they have. It may not be a bidding war we can win, but I definitely think we can take care of our athletes.
Very good. You know what? I think the greatest victory is ahead, whatever that is. Would you agree?
I do. I think the greatest thing in coaching is you think your best game or your best team is still ahead of you. And, you know, I'm excited for that. I think it is.
Thank you.
Thank you.